31. In car number 15, Evan Marchand from Somerset, Mass. Teddy Welch in car number 11. Tyler Alkiss occupying car number 89. Ethan Simmons in 04. Nicholas Hovey in the 16. Ari Jensik in the 71. Her brother Connor Jensik in car number 87. Then in the 51, Sawyer Reese from Guilford. The M16 belongs to Madeline Hovey. In car number 40, Evelyn Simmons. And then in car number 2, from East Hampton, Connecticut, Aiden Sullivan. That is our field. The peace car is ready to go down under, and we are ready to hit the spotlight with our Bandolero divisions. 20 laps as they swirl off the corner and get ready to take the green flag. It is Maddie Harkins showing some early firepower as she scoots out into the lead. Hanging to the outside is PJ Evans, but he is in danger of losing the spot. Here comes Emma Monahan in car number 78, and she is going to razzle-dazzle her way into the number 2 spot. She is trailed by the fourth generation driver. That is Evan Marchand in car number 15. His grandmother actually had a victory at the Waterford Speedbowl. He is in third. Then it's Tyler Alkiss who tucks it into fourth. But the man with the driver with all the glitz and glimmer at the front of the field, that is Maddie Harkins. So Harkins trying to run and hide, finding it very difficult to do. Emma Monahan is right there with her. And then it is a guy only racing for the second time at the Speedbowl. That's Evan Marchand. He raced at Seacock on Friday night and finished third. Made a pretty good spirited comeback in order to do that. Alkiss in fourth. So the top four cars could fit in the cowboy hat. But the driver with the biggest sharpshooter is the number 4 of Maddie Harkins. Her teammate gets out of line. It's Evan Marchand as he is looking for some firepower on the outside, but couldn't find enough to get that number 2 spot away from Emma Monahan. Great battle for fifth. Look at Nick Hovey. He's holding off Ari Jensik. So Ari Jensik, she is Velcroed to the back bumper of the number 16 car. Scurry their way into turn number 2, and Maddie Harkins looking for her third win of the year. She has a steady lead. Evan Marchand making some progress on the outside. His coach said we can expect to see a lot more from Evan this week, as he really was perplexed in his initial outing at the Speedbowl last week. He looks much smoother now as he torpedoes his way into a potential bid for second place. But it is nothing but blue skies up ahead for Maddie Harkin, a driver known as Mad Dog. And she has the loudest bark. Now things are really getting intriguing for fifth place as Hovey has his hands full holding off Ari Jensik. Brody Monahan is in the picture, currently in seventh place. Then we have Teddy Welch running eighth. Evans is dropped back as he started up at the front. The best battle is for second and third. Once again, wandering to the outside is Evan Marchand, looking for some bite against Emma Monahan. Let's see if he can find it. As they are able to dive bomb their way off the corner, and Emma has her fingerprints all over second place. Once again, here comes Marchand. Outside groove. With his footage to the outside, work for Evan. And he almost bobbled coming off of turn number 2. Had to get it back into control. We are quickly at the halfway mark of this one. And every step of the way has been dominated by Maddie Harkin. Started up at the front and has led every lap. Here comes your teammate, Evan Marchand, the fourth generation driver. He is able to whistle his way into second by a natural over Emma. So that is a Donnybrook for second and third.
Yellow.
And now the yellow comes out. So we have a problem. Last week's winner, Ethan Simmons, is in disarray in between turns 1 and 2. So that is a reason for the problem to be gone by the end of the night. So if you want to be a part of the summer showdown, have your name, your business announced over our PA system. We'll do a good job to get you the publicity that you deserve. So if you want to be part of a big night, see Mike Soroka tonight, and he will arrange it that you can have your name and your business as part of our Summer Showdown sponsorship. Right now, the showdown on the restart will not count as the yellow quickly comes back out. So things look a little unsettled. And we know we can do better than that, so we'll try again. Maddie Harkin started on the pole. Emma Monahan started third, has spent most of the night in second before just giving the spot up to Evan Marchand, who started fifth. Remember, if you would like to be part of the Summer Showdown, all you have to do is see Mike Soroka, and he will set it up. As we are down to single digits as far as our laps are concerned. But I looked at the list. Some pretty good numbers are still available. So you could be a big factor in Saturday's race. Who will be a big factor on the restart? Maddie Harkins gets out to an early edge. We'll see if that will stick, and apparently it will. Oh, now the yellow comes out. So that was short-lived success for Maddie Harkins. And we will regroup. Blaze Boulder, Mr. Blazing Saddles himself, is working with us again. He'll be your host for Victory Lane. And we will be hearing from him quite often during the course of the night. But so far, we have been hearing from Maddie Harkin, who has been the dominant factor. It almost looks like identical twins in the front row. What was that? Mary Kate and Ashley Olson. Well, the Olson twins aren't in the front row. It only looks that way. Let's see what happens as we go back to work. And pouncing on the restart is Maddie, the Mad Dog, as she has come out of the kennel in a hurry. And here comes Emma Monahan, regaining second place. So a fruitful restart for Emma Monahan, and now third is up for grabs. On the inside is Nick Hovey. On the outside is Evan Marchand, and trouble! A little boot scooting buggy for Nick Hovey. If that was not Dancing in the Stars, he would be the big winner. As that car had a little sneezing attack, and he was able to keep it under control, but he lost about three positions on the track. And that enabled Maddie Harkin to beef up the lead, so it is a three-way battle for the top spot. Maddie Harkin leading by about a tree branch over Emma Monahan. And she is leading by a $5 footlong over Evan Marchand. Tyler Alkus is running fourth. Then in fifth, a pretty good comeback by PJ Evans. He had dropped out of the top 10 for a while, and now he is in fifth. So a pretty good resurrection there by PJ. And also a good recovery by Ethan Simmons. You see that orange number 04 car, the Texas Roadhouse sponsored machine, trying to rabble rouse its way back to the front. But the drama is located in the front row. That's where Maddie Harkins is trying to hold off Emma Monahan. Emma Monahan with one win this year, Maddie Harkins with two, and we are down to the final five laps. Making things interesting is Evan Marchand. Remember, this fourth-generation driver is making only his second speedbowl appearance. A tight battle for fourth and fifth between Tyler Alkus and PJ Evans. So that car has quickly gotten some giddy-up for PJ. Back at the front, it is still Maddie Harkins with a cozy lead over Emma Monahan. Leading by about the length of a Q-stick over the number 78. And she is able to jackhammer her way off the corner. And there's just three laps separating her and a victory. Now here comes Maddie, getting by one of the slower cars. And it's been about 3 weeks since Maddie Harkin has last visited Victory Lane. It looks like she is on her way to making a return engagement. And they screech off the corner. Trouble for Eden Marchand. A good job by Eric Jensen to avoid him. The same could be said for Brody Monahan. The field looks a little different as Evan Marchand is now at the rear after the yellow came out with three to go. And it is Maddie Harkin will have to hold off Emma Monahan on this double foul restart. And Emma is usually pretty good on these restarts, so this should be a tussle. And a three-lap scoot for the lead, and the leader is Maddie Harkins, who is able to get away again. As she looks like soda out of a shaken can, reestablishing herself in front. Third is a dogfight between Tyler Alkis. He is on the inside. And the guy who has come from the dark shadows in the back, P.J. Evans, now Nick Hovey tries to get underneath the 21 car. And it's Hovey in fourth, Brody Monahan trying to make the identical move. And Brody Monahan is on the verge of infiltrating the top five. But you cannot rattle the cage of Maddie Harkin. The Mad Dog is one lap away from victory. And we'll see if Emma Monahan can do something about it. As they are able to blister their way down the backstretch for the final time. Maddie Harkin looking to win and looking to take over the point lead. We have problems on the backstretch. We stay under green and Maddie Harkin will win it. In second, Emma Monahan. Then it was Tyler Alkis in third. In fourth,
Maddie, you held off the field quite well tonight. Your cart was right on tune.
Yeah, I have to thank my dad. He works on the car more than he does his own job, and he also has a blown-out back, so it's been a rough week for us, but I definitely have to thank him the most.
Well, congratulations to you for a great win tonight.
Thank you.
Maddie Harkin, ladies and gentlemen, your winner tonight here at the Bandolero Series. And Matt?
And finishing second, Emma Monahan back on the podium, and she is getting ready to talk to Blaze Broder.
Thank you, Matt. Once again, we'll make our way over here to Emma. Congratulations to you. We thought it was going to get a little dicey at the end there.
Everybody kept coming down, kept trying to hit my doors, but every time they did, I just went under the white line, so I had to protect my spot because podium is more important than the infield.
Right, you're racking up the points as you go, but a great job tonight, finishing second.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Do anybody want to thank Emma?
I got to thank ECE, Team Critical, Race Choice, Sarah, Bryn, my grandparents, my aunt, my uncle, their two kids, my dad, my mom, Big G, Little G, Tick Mike. Yeah.
No bunch. Okay, congratulations to you.
Thank you.
And a solid run for third tonight was turned in by a man from Berlin, Connecticut, Tyler Alkis.
Tyler, you got a podium again, buddy. It's good to see you here.
Yeah, tough race, definitely. If that caution had come out the end, I don't think we would have had a podium. An awesome race. I thought the 21 could have had me. I tried my best. Third is better than fourth or whatever. Third is better than last. I thank all my sponsors, AccuLift, Avery's Beverages, Critical Tent, and hopefully we could come out here next week and park it down to Victory Lane.
Well, congratulations to you. We hope to see you in Victory Lane.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, Matt, we'll be right back.
Thank you.